Some colleges in this country have decided to coddle students to the point where they no longer will hand out failing grades. True story. We're becoming a nation that's so spoiled and privileged that we can no longer accept our own shortcomings. Here's your trophy, Johnny.
Right.
And Johnny says, what's the trophy for? Well, you showed up. You didn't win.
You paid your tuition.
You didn't win a damn thing. Didn't win a game. You know, never scored anything. But here's your trophy. Isn't that the thinking here?
Right.
Isn't that what's going on?
It is. And it's the snowflake world. This is where, you know, we're paying a lot for this. You know, and if I can't pass the class, then the teacher may lose their job. They have to give them extra credit to get caught up because they wouldn't do the basic assignment. I mean, Mike, you know, there was a time when I know at Florida, even at Ole Miss, where I went, is that you had you knew there were going to be tough teachers.
Yeah.
And to get through that class, you work your tail off, but you accomplish something.
Yeah.
Now in this world, everybody's going to get through that class.
Okay, so Oregon, I'm not making this. I could not make this up. Oregon University says, little Johnny, we're never going to give out D's or F's. So you know, just show up and you're going to make a C. Here's your trophy, little Johnny. That's what the hell's happening. It's just like when MIT, you had MIT and what was it, Purdue, Dartmouth. Okay, MIT and Dartmouth had a policy that they put in place about a year and a half ago. You don't have to take an SAT or an ACT to get in. Well, they just changed that because they thought it was an absolute disaster. The kids that they were letting in without the SAT or the ACT, hell, they couldn't write a sentence. They couldn't make it through the class. And so all of a sudden they decided, well, maybe we ought to go back and find out whether this person can read or write a damn sentence before we let them into Dartmouth. You understand what I'm saying?
Well, it's you know, the impacts on the workforce. You know who you hire. I mean, y'all want the best attorneys you can get out of college.
Yeah.
You know, you want them. If they're able to, you know, if everyone gets passed, you know, now the next thing they'll do is they'll lower the standards on the law exam. You know.
What if you're a nurse? Okay. Don't you want a nurse who actually knows that might have gotten an F, but went back and did it again and got an A?
Right.
Or what if you're an engineer? I mean, if you want your engineer to be able to calculate, is this damn building going to fall on us?
Right.
Or you certainly want your doctor to pass an anatomy test, don't you?
Right.
And you're saying, oh, well, look, doc, we never gave you your D or F. And when you came out here to practice, you didn't realize really where the kidneys were.
Well, you just think about, you know, you have all the things you have to pass to make it to med school. If you pass everything.
Yeah.
You know, the quality of worker. We keep saying we want better workers. We need more educated workers. We need thinkers.
Hell, we're having to bring them in. We're bringing them from Asia. We're bringing them from Europe just to fill some of the slots where they still give out D's and F's in Asia and Europe.
Right.
And I, this is such a bad policy, and I'm hoping it'll die on the vine. It seems to already be doing that with at least Dartmouth and MIT said, boy, what did we screw up. What a big mistake. At Oregon University, though, you might, if you have problems passing class, enroll at Oregon University, and they're going to provide, failure. They're going to teach you how to fail without ever really having any suffering because of it. That's kind of the story. That's the headline. Oregon University, sign up if you got problems making classes. The Gemini controversy with Google. This is
the one I wanted to talk about.
Well, I know you do because this, I mean, again, you're in the independent news business. You've got the best progressive newspaper clearly in the state. Tell me your take on this with Gemini controversy where, God, it's like Google has lost their friggin' mind.
Well, you know, they had to pump the brakes on Gemini. It's an AI image generator. You know, it came up with black founding fathers, a female pope, Asian German Nazis. People asked for straight couples, and they got pictures of gay couples. It is where the whole problem is that the way they said was, well, we missed the mark. That we overcompensated to show diversity.
They were representing female popes.
Right.
They were representing African American who were Nazi SS soldiers.
Right.
You think they might have gotten it wrong? You know?
Well, there are no guardrails.
No guardrails.
The difference is, I think, in trying to read what Google posted on their website and look at it, they were so worried about gender diversity. So if someone put in CEO, that it wouldn't be all male CEOs, but whatever. But when you do that, when you start your Google search is about not what the world is, but what the world you wanted to be, your dream world.
So what they did, Rick, I mean, they hit the DEI button, right? Low DEI. They let the algorithms take it from there. The algorithms went crazy. And all of a sudden, you have this garbage. I mean, absolute garbage. Now, they say, oh, we can fix it. You can't fix this quickly. You agree with that?
Well, it's the same people who made it are going to fix it. And they rushed it. We know that. They rushed this. And it is all about the algorithm, Mike. Yeah. We know that just in ordinary searches, the people that get moved up in the search are the ones that have figured out how to rig the system or have paid to be hired.
Isn't this an opportunity for Microsoft and Bing and Yahoo to at once, you have to do something about the reach of Google.
Right.
Google has become so strong that nobody thinks, I don't think to go to Bing, and I will now, I mean Microsoft or any of that. Those are great search sites. I mean, they really are good search sites. But Google has moved into this area to such that that we allow them to do this kind of insanity.
Right.
Absolute insanity, where if a child does a search, tell me about Nazi soldiers, and an African-American soldier comes up with an SS insignia on the side of his helmet, or tell us about who the popes have been, and some female fabricated pope shows up. It's insanity in the way that we're trying to project ideas and concepts, isn't it?
It is, because we used to see, in the early days of the computer, we would get on a search engine and try to find really interesting websites because everything was new to us. We didn't, you would put in, if you were going somewhere, you'd put that location in and they would tell you, you would find fascinating websites that were different and it was fun and you trusted it.
How can you trust Google now?
You can't.
After this story.
Right.
It's not just the AI, it's not just the Gemini issue. It's the site in general. How do we know what they're pushing or what they're throttling back? We know when we do stories, and I know you've seen the same thing, when we do a story that doesn't gel with their political concept, they throttle it back.
Right.
There's no question about it. They will throttle it back. And so how do we trust them at all as it is, much less when we know now that their AI has gone frigging crazy and making stuff up?
Right.
Just absolutely making stuff up out of thin air.
Well, if that was your main source for getting information, you can't do it. But we're at this point, AI is generating a lot of things out there for news networks and for news websites that are totally clickbait. And you have to go back to the source. But if Google is your source, you're already screwed.
Well, they count on people are stupid. I mean, that's what Google counts
or
on.
Lazy.
No, lazy and stupid.
Okay.
And yeah, there may be a generation where when you see an African-American soldier with an SS helmet on God, I didn't know that happened. And all of a sudden, that's what they're believing.
Right.
You know, but they don't seem overly upset about this, Rick. I mean, if you look at their responses, well, we didn't do it exactly right. You think?
Right.
We didn't do it exactly right. And then when you really test them on what they throttle back and what they push ahead, where it comes to politics. I mean, they 5 days of hearings in Congress where it was very clear how they were throttling politics, you know?
Well, they come back and, the CEO says, well, we're not perfect. We're emerging technology. Yeah, but before you put unleash it.
Yeah. Google's become a shallow bureaucratic train wreck. And they really have.
Well, they've all become very fat.
And the leadership there, somebody has got, there's got to be a wake-up call and say, look, people want information. They don't want to be socialized a certain way. They don't want you making up crap and telling that this is truth in the world.
Right.
Right. Rick, thanks for joining me.
Oh, okay? It was fun. We'll have a discussion later.
That's all for this week. But all these segments are going to be posted right here on this channel in the coming week. Make sure you subscribe. I'm Mike Papantonio, and this has been America's Lawyer, where we tell you stories every week that corporate media won't tell you because their advertisers simply won't let them. They don't want to make the advertiser mad, so they don't tell this story on a pharmaceutical, on the weapons industry, on Wall Street, whatever it may be. Or their political contact is so Democrat or it's so Republican that they can't tell anything in the middle. They can't even tell you the story in the middle. We don't have that problem around here, as you've seen from this show, so we hope to see you next time.